ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिके मूकं करति वाचालं पिंगलं गयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे श्रीगुरुं दीनतारणं श्रीपरमानन्दमाधवम्। So today we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, chapter 10, text 11. Jivan mritatvam niyamena rajan adyantavadyad vikritasya drishtam स्वसम्य भावो ध्रुवैड्य यत्र तर्हि उच्यते सौविधिकृत्य योगः जीवन्मृतत्वं नियमेन राजन् अद्यन्तवद्यद् विकृतस्य दृष्टम् स्वसाम्यभावो ध्रुवैड्य यत्र तर्हि उच्यते सौविधिकृत्य योगः जीवन्मृतत्वं नियमेन राजन् आद्यन्तवद्यद् विकृतस्य दृष्टम् स्वस्वाम्यभावो ध्रुवैड्यजत्र तर्हि उच्यते सौविधिकृत्य योगः। तत्त्वं नियमेन राजन् अद्यन्तवद्यद् विकृतस्य दृष्टम् स्वसाम्यभावो ध्रुवैड्य यत्र तर्हि उच्यते सौविधिकृत्य योगः तन्मृतत्वं नियमेन राजन् अद्यन्तवत्कृत्वविकृतस्य दृष्टम् स्वसाम्यभावो ध्रुवैड्ययत्र युच्यते सौविधिकृत्य योगः। Mataji's Jivan Mrutatvam Niyame Narajan Abhyantavatkrtavipasadrishtam Asamnabhavadruvayidhyayatra Tayochyate Sauvidhikritta Yoga Jivan Mrutatvam. The quality of being dead while living. Niyamena, by the laws of nature. Rajan, O King. Adi Antavat, everything material has a beginning and an end. Yat, because. Vikritasya, of things that are transformed, such as the body. Drishtam is seen. So samyabhava, the condition of servanthood and mastership. Dhruva, unchangeable. Idya, O you who are worshipped, yatra, wherein, tarhi, then, uchyate, it is said, aso, that, vidhi kritya yoga, fitness of order and duty. Translation purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada. Translation. My dear King, you have unnecessarily accused me of being dead though alive. In this regard, I can only say that this is the case everywhere, because everything material has its beginning and an end. As far as you are thinking that you are the king and master and are thus trying to order me, this is also incorrect, because these positions are temporary. Today you are a king and I am your servant, but tomorrow the position may be changed and you may be my servant and I your master. These are temporary circumstances created by providence. Purport. The bodily conception is the basic principle of suffering in material existence. In Kali Yuga especially, people are so uneducated that they cannot even understand that the body is changing at every moment, and that the ultimate change is called death. In this life, one may be a king, and in the next life, one may be a dog according to karma. The spirit soul is in a deep slumber caused by the force of material nature. He is put in one type of condition and again changed into another type. Without self-realization and knowledge, conditional life continues, and one falsely claims himself a king, a servant, a cat, or a dog. These are simply different transformations brought about by the supreme arrangement. One should not be misled by such temporary bodily conceptions. Actually, no one is master within the material world, for everyone is under the control of material nature, which is under the control of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is the ultimate master. As explained in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Ekale Ishvara Krishna आर सव भृत्य द ओनली मास्टर इज कृष्ण एंड एवरी वन एल्स इज इज सर्वेंट फॉरगेटफुलनेस ऑफ अर रिलेशनशिप विद द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड brings about our suffering in this material world. Om Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदामयं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवंश श्रीरूपं सग्रजातं सगणरघुनाथ नितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितं च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कंत राधा कंत नमस्ते तप्त कंचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिसे नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे जीवन मृतत्वं नियमेन राजन आद्यन्तवत् यद् विकृतस्य दृष्टं स्वसम्य भावो ध्रुव इड्य यत्र तर्युच्यते सौ विधिकृत्य योगः. सो हियर इन दिस वर्स ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम जड़ भरत is answering the accusations of Maharaja Rahugana. As we all know, that Maharaja Rahugana, who was the king of Sindhu Savira province, was going to Kapilashram. And on the way, his palanquin carriers wanted a man who could carry the palanquin with them. So they found a strong and stout person as Jada Bharata, and they engaged him to carry the palanquin of Maharaj Rahugana. And Jada Bharata, he had taken a vow not to. He was acting, actually he was acting like a deaf and dumb person. Knowingly he was doing that, so people would not bother him. And he could think about the Supreme Personality of Godhead without any hindrance. But material world is such that even if he was acting as a dumb and deaf person, still people are bothering him. So in this case, the palanquin carriers found him as the fittest person to carry the palanquin of the king. And since Jadabharata would not speak anything or would not object, because he was acting like a dumb person, so he had no choice. He was carrying the palanquin of Maharaj Rahugan, though he was not the fittest person for this. But when he was carrying the palanquin of Maharaj Rahugana, the palanquin was shaking, because Jadabharata, while he was putting his step, he was looking for 3 feet ahead, that there would be no ants or any other insects. So he did not want to step on those ants or insects. Because he was a self-realized person and he was very merciful towards all living entities, that's why he did not even want to step on ants. So while carrying the palanquin, he was following the principle of not stepping on ants or other insects. So while doing this, he was slow. He could not keep the pace with other palanquin carriers. That's why the palanquin was moving or shaking, because they were carrying unevenly. And King Rahugana, initially he cautioned the palanquin carriers, but when again and again his order was not carried out, and it was pointed out by other palanquin carriers that Jadabharata was the reason of the shaking of the palanquin, so King Rahugana criticized Jadabharata. Though he was strong and stout, the king said, "You are a very lean and thin person." He was sarcastically saying this to Jadabharata. "You are very tired, you are a very old man. So you must be feeling very tired to carry the palanquin." In this way he was criticizing Jadabharata. But Jadabharata, as he was a self-realized person, he was not in the bodily conception of life, he did not bother about the criticism of the king. And he was following the way he was carrying the palanquin, but he was still following his principle of not stepping on ants or insects. And again the palanquin was shaking. This time, King Rahugana became very, very angry on Jadabharata. And he accused him that you are a dead person while living. Jivan Mruta, that word is used here. That you are a dead person while living. He said that you are a dead person? Because you are not carrying out my order or my instruction. It is not bothering you. So you are not acting like a living person. You are acting like a dead person. Like a dead person would not react to anything. A dead body, if you hit the dead body would not react. So in the same way, Jadabharata was not reacting to anything. That's why the king said, though you are walking, you are a living person, but you are acting like a dead man. Jivan Mruta. And then he said that if you don't listen to me, I am your master. You are my servant, I can punish you. He was threatening to Jadabharata. So in this way, Jadabharata was accused by the king, and now Jadabharata, though he was acting like a dumb and deep person, now he became very merciful towards this foolish king who was accusing him. Not because of his accusation, but the king was in great illusion. That's why Jadabharata wanted to give him transcendental knowledge. This was his mercy on King Rahugana. So the great personalities, those who are self-realized souls, they are always merciful towards other living entities. The mercy not only is seen in not killing any other living entity, the mercy, real mercy is seen when a transcendentalist or a self-realized person gives this transcendental knowledge to others. That is the real mercy. So here we see that Jadabharata wanted to become merciful towards King Rahugana. That's why, though he was acting like a dumb and deaf person, now he opened his mouth for the first time in this life. From his very birth, he had not opened his mouth. He was not speaking. But just to show his mercy to King Rahugana, he opened his mouth for the first time. And by opening his mouth, he gave this transcendental knowledge to King Rahugana. So he said, Jivan mrutattam niyamena rajan adyantavat vikrutasya drishtam. So he said, O king, you have accused me as Jivan Mruta. Though I am living, but I am acting like a dead person. But actually, Jadabharata said that in your viewpoint, I am not only the dead person while living. I am not only Jivan Mruta. There are so many persons in this material world. They are also Jivan Mruta. Though they are living person, living entities, but they are like dead persons, dead entities. And why? He said, I am not only Jivan Mruta, there are so many other entities are also Jivan Mruta. And why they are Jivan Mruta? Because the living entities who identify with their material body, the body is made of dull matter. So those who identify with the material body and act to satisfy the material body, that becomes the goal of their life. They want to satisfy their senses, material senses. And they think that is the goal of their life. So they are considered Jivan Mruta. Though they are living, they are actually dead. Apranasya vadehasya mandanam lokaranjan. Like when you decorate a dead body, this is just lokaranjan, it has no value. If you decorate very nicely, spending millions of rupees to decorate the dead body, what is the use? No use. And only lokaranjanam, only pleasing to other people. Oh, he decorated this body so nicely. That's all. So, here in this material world, people, those who are identifying with their material bodies, and they are decorating their bodies very nicely, they are trying to satisfy that body or bodily senses, they are actually acting like dead personalities. So it has been stated in Srimad Bhagavatam, Mother Devahuti is speaking to Kardama Muni, her husband. Nehayat karma dharmaya. So people in this material world, they perform different activities. But if their activities are not leading to dharma or perform to satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And what is dharma? Dharma to sakshat bhagavata pranitam, to carry out the instruction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So if someone is performing activities in this material world, but it is not meant to satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead, it is not meant to perform dharma, then that karma or activity is useless. But if someone is performing activity or to satisfy the Supreme Lord, but it is na viragaya kalpate, but it is not leading him to vairagya, renunciation. Someone is performing religious activities, pious activities, but if those activities are not leading to a person for renunciation, then those religious or pious activities becomes useless. But if someone is performing pious activities and he is developing renunciation within his heart, but na tirtha pyada sevai, but even if he has developed renunciation, but still he has not rendered devotional service at the lotus feet of Tirthapada, means in whose lotus feet all the places of pilgrimage reside, means Krishna, who is called Tirthapada. So if one is not performing activities or serving the lotus feet of the Lord, then his pious activities, his renunciation becomes useless. So those who do this, like perform activities, but it does not lead to pious activity, and they perform pious activity, it does not lead to renunciation, and if they are renounced, but still they don't serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then those persons are to be called jivan api mruto hisa. Though they are living, they are called dead persons. So they are called jivan mruta, those who do not serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead, those who serve their material senses, those who serve their material body. These persons are to be called jivan mruta. So here, when we hear about jivan mruta, then the opposite is jivan mukta, those who are living, but at the same time they are liberated. While living, they are liberated. So who are they? Who can be called jivan mukta? Iha yasya harer dasya karmana manasa bacha gira. So those who by mind, words and activities, karmana manasa gira, akhilaswapi avasthasu jivan mukta sauchyate. So those who think themselves and act also, those who think in their mind that they are the servant of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and not only they think, they also act in that capacity. They act like a servant of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Karmana and manasa, then vacha, and they also speak like a servant of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So when someone does like this, then he is called jivan mukta. While living in this material world, he is to be considered a liberated soul. So here, jivan mrutatang niyamena rajan. So Jadabharata is speaking that, dear king, you have accused me as jivan mruta because I am not carrying your palanquin evenly or properly. That's why you have accused me as jivan mruta. While living, I am dead personality. But I am not only dead personality in this material world, according to your calculation. All those personalities we see in this material world, those who work to satisfy their material senses, to satisfy their material bodies, they are all to be considered jivan mruta. Here also, Srila Madhvacharya, he has also given the same definition about jivan mruta. So Srila Madhvacharya says, prana yukte aratya cha jadam jivan mritam. So Madhvacharya says, jivan mritam smritam iti cha. So those personalities to be called jivan mrita, prana yukte aratya cha jadam. Even if those personalities, those who are with life, means they have life, or they are living, prana yukte, or atya, means even if they are living, but they have no rati, or attachment, or love for the Supreme Personality of Godhead, they are actually jada. They are actually, though living, they are dull matter. That's why they are to be called jivan mrutam smrita. So they are called jivan mrita. And then Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur also says, jivan mrutatam yadi tvaya mama dehabhimanitam eva nirdharitam tadapi jivan mrutatam niyamena mameva kevalam na. So Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur also telling the same thing, that Jadabharata is speaking to Maharaj Rahugana, that dear king, if you are thinking me as jivan mruta because I am identifying with my material body, so this thing is sarvasaiva vikrutasya parinama drishtam pratyakshameva. But this thing, according to your calculation, this thing has to be seen everywhere in this material world. That most of the people in this material world, they are all identifying with their body, and those who are identifying with their body, that body made of dull matter. The body is made of pancha mahabhuta, डल मैटर क्षिति ऑफ तेज मरुत व्यम. सो एनी डल मैटर इन दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड वी सी हैज ए बिगिनिंग एंड हैज एन एंड. सो दिस मेटेरियल बॉडी व्हिच वी लव वेरी मच एंड वी आइडेंटिफाई विथ दिस मेटेरियल बॉडी, वी थिंक वी आर दिस मेटेरियल बॉडी. सो दिस मेटेरियल बॉडी हैज ऑल्सो ए बिगिनिंग एंड एन एंड. द बॉडी टेक्स बर्थ, इट स्टेज फॉर सम टाइम एंड देन एट लास्ट द बॉडी इज डेड. सो एवरीथिंग हैज ए बिगिनिंग हैज एन एंड. सो दिस इज हैपनिंग एवरीवेयर इन दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड. सो इनडायरेक्टली जड़ भरत इज स्पीकिंग टू महाराज राहुगण दैट बिकॉज राहुगण वॉज थिंकिंग हिमसेल्फ एज अ किंग एंड ही वॉज ऑर्डरिंग जड़ भरत, सो ही वॉज ऑल्सो आइडेंटिफाइंग विथ हिज ओन बॉडी. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ स्पीकिंग टू जड़ भरत एज जीवन मृत, ही ऑल्सो इज ऑल्सो जीवन मृत. द किंग इज ऑल्सो जीवन मृत, दो ही इज लिविंग इज ऑल्सो ए डेड पर्सनैलिटी. एंड देन ही इज रेफ्यूटिंग अनदर एक्यूजेशन हियर इन दिस वर्स. वी से स्व साम्य भाव, स्व मीन्स मी एंड स्वामी मीन्स मास्टर. सो द किंग इज थिंकिंग that he is the master, because he is the king, he is the master and I am his servant. That's why he is ordering me. So swamya bhava dhruvam idya yatra. So jada bharata says that this is true, that you are thinking as a king, you are my master and I am your servant. And this conception prevails in this material world. Someone thinks himself as master and someone thinks that he is the servant, or the master thinks he is my servant. This is going on in this material world. Someone is master and someone is servant. And this thing happens because one identifies with his own body. The body has taken birth in a particular family or in a particular, from a particular person or in a particular race. That's why the illusioned living entity thinks he is the master of everyone and others are his servants. But this thing in this material world is also temporary. The identification with this material body and thinking oneself as the master of everyone is also temporary. So Jada Bharata says that so samya bhavo dhruva idya yatra. So this is true. What you are speaking, now you are my master, you are the king, and I am your servant. This is true. For the time being, this is true. But this is not true ultimately. Because in this material world, everything changes. The body changes, the circumstances changes, and the position also changes according to the change of the material body. So someone in this life, Srila Prabhupada says, he is a king, but next life he will take the body of a dog or a hog according to his karma. So whatever activity we perform in this material world, accordingly, we are going to get another material body in the next life. And as long as we will be identifying with our material body, we will go on continuing taking material bodies one after another. So in this way, sometimes we will become king, sometimes we will become servant, sometimes we will become a hog, sometimes we will become a dog, sometimes we will become an insect. So these things are going on in this material world. So these positions, according to material body, our positions are temporary. This will be changing again and again. So Jadabharata says, Tairu chate asu vidhikrutte yoga. And these things are determined not by ourselves, but by vidhi, by providence. By the supreme providence, the things are arranged for us. We don't determine what body we are going to take in our next life. This is determined according to our karma, this is determined by providence, by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And we have no control over it. So Jadabharata is saying to the king, Rahuvana, that my dear king, now you have become the king and you are thinking you are the master of everyone. And you are ordering me, thinking me as your servant. But according to providence, if things will change, if things will change and I will become the king, and you will become my servant. Because this thing happens. This life someone is the king, next life he will become servant. And the person who has acted like a servant, he can become a king according to his karma. So the position changes. So Jadabharata says that according to providence, if even in this lifetime, what to speak of next lifetime? Providence is so powerful, we see in this material world. Someone is very rich person in this material world. But by providence, it happens that the rich person, his wealth is taken away. The richest person, he becomes the poorest person in this material world. He becomes very poor person. And the person who was poor, who had no wealth, suddenly he becomes very rich. That we see in this material world also. In this lifetime, what to speak of? Next lifetime. In this lifetime, it also happens. Someone has become a very big, rich person, suddenly he becomes very poor. His wealth is taken away by providence. And a poor person, immediately he becomes a rich person. So he becomes the master. The richest person who was the master previously, by providence or providential arrangement, he becomes poor, and he becomes a servant. And the poor person who was a servant before, he becomes a rich person, he becomes the master. The position changes. The master becomes servant, the servant becomes master. Then, in that situation, Jadabharata is asking,